Manga is back in Manila. Former President Joseph Estrada's first term as Manila mayor took off with what appears to be a hell-bent intention to sweep the capital of corruption, crime, and poverty. Estrada says he's determined to restore Manila to glory, and he wants results in 100 days. So joining us in the studio, former President and now Manila Mayor Joseph Estrada. Mr. President, Mayor, I think I should start calling you Mayor, sir.
Yeah, any.
Okay. Mayor Mayor Erap, magandang umaga po sa inyo, sir.
Magandang umaga naman, Pinky.
You know, it's been so hectic for you, I understand, you know, during the campaign, yeah. Sir. There were times nagkita po tayo, tapos you took your oath, tapos parabang, ang the way I saw it, sir, parang lumalabas napakaraming problema talaga ng Manila, yeah. More than you thought nung kayo'y nangangampanya. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
Yeah. Bottom line, what's so hard is so many people expecting so much is expected from me, but the problem is that the coffers of the city is bankrupt. I think it's a deficit of last year. This is 3.5 according to the report of the Commission on Audit. Now it's already about 5.5 billion deficit. And the allowances of the policemen for more than 2 years were not given. And the allowances of the teachers were reduced, and it's not given on time. So these are the problems. And of course, the peace and order is so bad. Policemen are involved in, extortion, kidnapping. As reported by the. Reported by the Philippine Highway Patrol. Mm. Oh, yeah. MPD 30 doesn't suit for kidnapping. And also reported by the Philippine Highway Patrol, Manila overtakes Quezon City as cartel capital, as the capital of carnappers in the Philippines.
Did you know this problem, sir, prior to your running?
Not all.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Because, sir, naalala ko na nag-uusap po tayo, sinasabi niya, gusto niyo ibalik yung glory ng Manila.
Yeah.
Of course, we talked about peace and order a lot. You talked about, rather, peace and order a lot. At saka, naalala ko, sir, sinasabi niyo before na napakataas ng antas ng Maynila noon. Mm-hmm. At ngayon ay na-overtake na siya ng ilang mga other cities.
It used to be the financial center of the Philippines. And you know, Manila is the capital city. It's the image of the country abroad. So now it's all the surrounding towns and cities overtook Manila already.
Hindi naman po, well, this is not going to be a problem for you in terms of experience because you were mayor of San Juan for a very long time, sir, bago po kayo naging senador, vice president, at pangulo ng Pilipinas. I know it's 100 days na yun, sir, but realistically, in the first 100 days, ano ho kaya maaaring magbago sa Manila?
Well, because as I've said earlier, walang pondong yan. So whatever project you want to implement, it boils down to funding, but you don't have funds. So I thought of my first 100 days of concentrating on the peace and order and going after all these hoodlums in uniforms or scalawags and then clean up Manila garbage.
Okay.
Not only garbage, but also corruption, even within the City Hall, not only among policemen, but even civilian employees.
All right, let's start with the City Hall, sir. Anong klaseng revamp? What kind of revamp has happened in the City Hall since you took over?
Well, in fact, just yesterday, we caught one employee extorting money from a driver. So we have to really have a clean up corruption, not only among the policemen, but among the City Hall employees. Mm. And to do that, because I believe that it was effective, because what you preach, you must practice. But if you preach and you don't practice it, nobody will believe you.
Mm. Mm.
So that's my experience in San Juan when I was mayor. So I declared an all-out war against corruption and against this cotton caps and against, of course, the drugs and petty crimes and those extorting money from poor people like the vendors. So this is the problem. And of course, the biggest problem is that Manila has a big deficit. And in fact, it's zero. Just last
that,
February 21st, it has not paid Meralco almost 600 million.
Okay, let's show this, Mayor. Okay, 600 million. The city of Manila owes Meralco a total of 600 million pesos.
598, to be exact.
Oh, 598 million pesos. So, Mayor, how do you intend to pay for this? Responsibilidad niyo ba ito ngayon?
Yeah, I believe so. We might, you know, I'm...
Where can you get 600 million pesos?
I asked our assessor to consolidate all the properties of the city. You might be able to sell some, or ask the government banks, like the land bank, to lend us money.
Okay, so it says that nung February po, nagbayad si Mayor Lim ng 133.4 million.
Yeah, after paying that, there's still the balance.
Pagkatapos, so. With the above payment as of today, the City of Manila's total unpaid electricity bills, exclusive of legal interest, still stands at 505,676,344 pesos and 26 centavos. Mayor, kayo po ay mayor dati. How can something like this happen?
I don't know. It never happened to me. And I think it never happened to other cities here in Metro Manila. It's only happening in Manila.
Apart over and above this, though, Mayor, meron ho ang utang, meron ho, according to the COA, there's about 3 billion pesos in debt owed by the City of Manila. In essence, how do you intend to make up for this? At ano ba ang uunahin mo, sir, na pagbayad ng utang?
I would say na first of all we can pay that hopefully because you know the computer in Manila was hacked. No? They didn't have any computer, only by manual. So the first thing I'll do is have it computerized and all the income paid to the municipality should be transparent and all expenditures should be also transparent. But now it's not transparent. So, and of course, we have to reassess again the property of the properties there in Manila because I think it's more than 4 or 5 years it has been reassessed.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll have to increase the, so that we can get more taxes.
And for obvious reasons, Mayor, mas mataas syempre ang market value ngayon than 4 or 5 years ago.
Oh, yes, yes.
Okay. Do you know how much income the city earns in a year?
Supposed to be 9.2 billion.
Annually, sir?
Annually.
Mm-hmm. And the expense, would you know?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
But at least we have to, like for example, last year, the city council appropriated 9.2 billion as the budget. But I think they were only able to collect about less than 5 billion. So there's a deficit already.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the allowances of the policemen are not paid. The allowances of the teachers were deducted.
So sila yung collateral damage.
Yeah.
Sila yung apektado because of this. Are there plans? How do you intend to raise the income of the City of Manila, sir?
Yeah, by saying to you that every single cent of the income should go to the city coffers.
Mm. No, but you talked about reassessing the value of Manila because the last time it was reassessed was 4 to 5 years ago. In effect, Mayor, kapag mangyari po to, yung taxes na posibleng bayaran ng mga establishments doon, tataas.
Yeah, well, according, I mean, it should be legal and because the properties have not been assessed for the 4 or 5 years.
Mm.
So we have to reassess that. In fact, you know, as you could see the graph and corruption there, and it's not it's not transparent, when it's not within the computer.
Yeah.
So it's manual, so they can fix it, no?
Pwedeng dagdagan ng zero.
Like for example, yung mga business permit. So they can, you know, the business license inspector can make talk to the one paying.
Yeah, the applicant.
Applicant.
Bigyan mo na lang konti dito.
Oh, baka mas malaki pa pumupunta ron.
Yeah.
Kisa sa government coffer.
So, marami naman ho kayong tao, Mayor, that alam mo na kung saan mo lalagay yung mga tao mo at lalagayin mo na yung mga taon to. Because hindi naman po sa inyo, hindi naman kayo pwede mag-micromanage nito. Mahihirapan naman kayo.
Yeah, of course. I delegate it to the person that I trust.
Yeah. And you have those in place already.
Yes.
And dyan na po silang lahat. Mm-hmm. The policeman, you're saying the, you want to rid the police of problems, kotong. That doon na po yung station commander that you sacked.
Yeah.
Okay. Because
they'll be coming. Some are coming.
So there are 11 station commanders, Mayor.
Yes.
So tatlong tinanggal nyo, ilan pang coming soon?
Walo pa. Not all. Well, we just don't remove them or relieve them without any evidence at all.
But they might say that, syempre, tinanggal mo kami, Mayor, dahil dati kami kay Mayor Lim.
No. I personally went around the Victoria and talked to the vendors themselves. And they're so afraid. But some are also brave enough to tell me. Although, it's not the station commander who were caught or they didn't pinpoint. But as I've said, it's been going on for years. And that's the command responsibility of the station commander. Not to know that, well, of course, that's impossible for the station commander. That's supposed to be the command responsibility of the station commander to know everything what's happening in this area.
So you mean meron pong kotong sa Maynila, meron pong carnapping sa Maynila, meron pong corruption sa Maynila. Ano pong maganda? What's if there's anything good that you've seen since you sat in office on June 1?
Well, of course, there'll be one that I'm in business. And I practice what I preach.
Yeah.
You say, you rule or you manage any position that you are in. You manage it by as a leader, as an example, that you practice what you preach.
How different, Mayor, would you say San Juan is from Manila in terms of improving the city?
Well, San Juan is now number two in terms of among all the Metro Manila mayors, cities. This is in the survey of the DILG, in terms of governance. And so the police are likened by the people, respected by the people, because they have already showed their capability as policemen, not unlike in Manila, Manila, the Manila Police Department used to be called Manila's Finest.
That's right.
But now it's Manila's Worst. You see? Yeah, I'm not saying this. It's even the government agency, even the Philippine National Patrol.
Highway Patrol. It's a tall order, gaya po ng sabi namin kanina, Mr. Mayor, no, Mayor Erap, yung gagawin sa Maynila. At after everything you've experienced, I'd really like to find out, nung lahat ng nadaanan nyo na Mayor, Senador, Vice President, President, syempre tapos na po yan, bumalik po kayo na Mayor. But do you still have the inyong lakas, mentally, physically, emotionally, na gawin po ito lahat?
Because I'm inspired because I was born in Manila, but doon ako sumikat. And one more thing, this is coming from my heart, Pinky. I think this is my last hurrah. And my last hurrah, I can see because the study of the UP professors, that Manila has the highest level of poverty incidents. Sa Manila, pinakamaraming mahirap sa Manila. And Manila has the most number of jobless people. So I said to myself, when I was incarcerated, you know, there's that saying, pag wala ka na sa pwesto, wala ka na sa poder, nakakalimutan ka ng tao, galit na sa'yo tao, or lalo na ako, hindi na ako nawala sa pwesto, pero nakulong pa ako kung ano nung black propaganda tinapon sa mukha ko. Ang sinubukan ko, kung talaga ano, sinubukan patakbuhin ang aking may bahay, si Dr. Aloy, si Juan, tapos si Jinggoy, natakbo ko rin, nanalo rin senador. So that, so sure that, yung masa, the poor people did not leave me, even if I was incarcerated. So I owe everything to the masa. And even as a movie actor, it's the masa who patronized my movies. Yung mga, ano, you see. So this is my, I'm still strong. Mm-mm. And they did not leave me. So I can't leave them. Mm-mm. I can still do something for them.
Is this a province mayor na tatlong taon lang ho kayo sa
yes.
Manila? Tapos ililipat nyo na po kay Isko?
Yeah. Mm. He's a very competent and intelligent vice mayor.
So, you nakikita niyo po yung sarili niya, 3 years from now, you're done with politics completely? Mm-hmm. And you're just gonna enjoy your life?
Yeah. I'll be 79 by then.
79.
I think it's time to retire.
Yeah, and you know, you have two sons now as senators. Of course, yeah. Senator Jinggoy has another 3 years. Senator JV has 6 years to go. And who knows what's in store for Senator Jinggoy Estrada. He may run as vice president.
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Titingnan, of course, that's subject to what happens in the next couple of years. But sir, meron ho kayong plans na napag-usapan nyo na. I wanted to discuss it also. You wanted, yung mga vendors kasi, sabi nyo, you want them out by, you had a deadline.
Oh yeah, maybe in a month's time.
In 1 month. Dapat tanggal na po itong mga...
Well, you know, era para sa mahirap. Ito mga may hirap eh. Tapos alisan ko pa ng hanap buhay. I mean, it's against my conscience. Kaya I have a plan for them. Na they can occupy the street. Because they're already in the street, in the middle of the street. So I plan to put up a night market. So they can occupy the same. But there's a time. They can start at 6 o'clock in the morning. But no, they can only start at 7 o'clock in the evening.
Gabi,
para wala ng traffic.
Yeah.
And then they leave at 6 o'clock in the morning.
So, para yung mga night market that we see abroad,
yeah.
Sir.
Yeah.
So,
and then I'll give them, wala ng kotong-kotong. You know, they pay 20, 50 pesos, 100 pesos a day. These cotton cups. So, I'll remove all that and then... They will not pay the city for, I mean, give them a break for about 3-4 months to have more investment.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. More. So that's the way I could help them.
Tapos after 4 months, sir, they start paying?
They start paying.
But where is this? Where do you plan to do this?
Well, in the same place where they were.
Adon din.
Only, really nothing. My time. They'll start only at 7 and then end up at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Were you ever thinking, mayor, of something like yung talagang parang night market na away
yeah.
from, di ba?
Well, some, it's not only one.
Yeah.
Other places that will put up a night market.
Were they very receptive about it? Kasi baka sinasabi nila, eh, sir naman, yung mga tao bumibilid, ano eh, pag-araw, hindi naman po paggabi, which is a fact.
They have to experience that experiment. Well, at first, there are some resistance, but then they have no choice, and we're giving them all these chances to earn money. So I think may not even collecting rental from them. So they're given all these chances.
Mayor, dun po sa port area. I did a story there, sir, nakalimutan ko na po yung area, pero yung road na yon papunta sa port area, sa kanan po, maraming informal settlers doon na yung mga wires sila na Meralco, talagang buhul-buhul na po. Sa kaliwa po, nandun po
yung malalaking truck. Na,
yung mga dump site. Oo, na napuntahan ko po. May plano ho ba kayo doon?
Of course, we'll clean that up. And, well, this is... I'm very glad that... President Noynoy announced that there will be a budget for all this relocation of informal settlers and the dredging of all these esteros. And there will, the Secretary of Public Works, Relio Babes Singson, who told me that there will be a big budget for the development of the stretch of the Ross Boulevard up to Del Pam Bridge. Well, that will really make Manila.
What's going to happen there, sir? Anong plano nila doon? Well, sa Ross Boulevard, that area?
Yung Ross Boulevard, yung beside the bay, they'll develop it as a park.
I see. So matitigil na rin yung mga tao.
That
okay.
will beautify Manila. That will be a big help. Mm-hmm. And especially in dredging all these steros and relocating all these informal settlers.
Didn't you meet with MMDH Chairman Francis
Valentino?
Ano po nangyari doon? Can you update
day.
Us?
Yeah, we will coordinate with these people, with these men, these engineers, these men and my other city engineers in Manila. I think we'll work as a team.
But yung sa pag-uusap niyo po, when you spoke to the chairman, Chairman Tolentino, what is the priority na pwede niyong pagtulungan?
Well, baka sabihin, of course, I have to ask him, can you tell the president and help me give priority to Manila? Because Manila is the most populated. Manila is the show window of the country. I hope that you give priority to Manila.
So, I guess the thing is, sir, you don't really have a line. Wala ho kayong communication or hindi niyo po. Would it be hard to... You really have to go through channels bago makarating kay Pinoy, sir? Ganun ho ba?
Well, I don't attempt, but if I can talk to his secretary, Secretary Singson, and the chairman of the MMDA, well, I don't like to bother him.
Okay.
Although I'm very...
It's so different, but when you're president...
Thankful to him that he gave a big budget for the relocation of the informal settlers, dredging of the steros, and the development of the Ross Boulevard. But I'm very thankful to the president.
But it's very humble of you, sir, to think that way, considering you're a former president. But anyway, you're never known to be mayabang naman na mayor, no? Kilala naman po kayong hindi talaga ganung klaseng tao. Well, you have a budget, so that's good. You're in touch with Secretary Singson, besides the DPWH.
Yeah.
Ano po niyo yun eh? Mm-hmm. Hawak niyo po yung area ng DPWH. So that dump site, sir, gusto ko balikan. I'm just so sorry, the name escapes me right now. Basta pagka nandun ka po sa kaling yun, nasa kanan yung mga informal settlers. How many informal settlers are there in your estimates, sir,
well,
na magagalaw?
It cannot be less than... I would say no less than 6,000
families. Sila ho ba yung nasa priority areas also na kailangan mag-transfer?
Especially those along the steros. They are the ones responsible for the,
Yeah.
And once we have these steros dredged and screened, we can have passenger boat through the water that will ease the traffic.
I remember, sir, that during the time of Mayor Lim, meron siyang pinagawang hospital doon sa Maynila that he was very proud of. Actually, to be honest, I saw it from afar. Hindi ko naman po talaga napasok. At mukha ho talagang maganda.
Alin?
Yung hospital na...
Ayaw muli yung Santa Ana Hospital.
Yes. Any plans by the mayor, you?
Well,
to improve
I'm not
that
trying
to
try to destroy my predecessor, no? But, those hospitals, of course, the hospital in Manila was conceived by the late Mayor Lacson. It was continued by Mayor Villegas. And then the hospital in Sampaloc was made by Mayor Bagat Singh. Then the one hospital in Tondo by Mayor Mel Lopez. I think, in fairness, Hospital Santa Ana Hospital by Mayor Lim and one hospital in Tondo. So, in short, as for me, as far as I'm concerned, and I have talked to the people and my advisors, putting up 6 hospitals in Manila is too much. The capital outlay is so big. The maintenance, how many doctors, nurses, attendants, and the maintenance is so big. When there are a national hospital like the PGH, San Lazaro Hospital, or Cedres Hospital, why make 6 hospitals? What we must do is, okay, sure, not 6 or just 2 or 3, no? And this mga major operation can be done by the national hospitals. And so you save more money. You know, what should be strengthened is the primary health hospital, the health centers, you know? Yung mga minor, mga birth, ano, should be there only, you know? Instead of, you know, you have 6 hospitals, but most of them have no medicine. No. That's the complaint of the public. Oh, what's the use of these 6 hospitals?
So what are you planning to do? Are you planning to reduce the 6 to 3, sir?
Well, we're still studying it. No, we're still studying it. Because it's eating a lot of the budget of the city. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. The use of having 6 hospitals and then people are complaining you gotta give them medicine.
No medicine? So yeah. They also complain of lack of doctors
lack
and nurses?
Lack of doctors. So one hospital there is only 1 doctor. Mm. You see, these are all, you have to study all this, you know. So that the budget, the finance of the city should be properly handled.
What about just little things, Mayor? Sabihin po natin like Malate, it used to be very popular among the youth. Do you have plans to right now to revive that? Because sige sir, papasagutin ko muna sa inyo yung dahil I wanted to bring up
another. I'm determined to do that because when I was young, I used to go there often. There are good restaurants there, and even the upper middle class used to go there, the elite, but now they don't go there anymore.
Yeah.
Because they're afraid of peace and order, so-called pimp, you know.
Yeah.
So it has really decayed a lot.
One person you tapped though, Mr. President, at ang balita ko, ikaw ang kumuha, ikaw ang nag-isip, is Carlos Sildran.
Yes.
Para buhayin yung tourist attractions sa Maynila. What happened there? Nakilala mo ba siya before?
No, but I heard about him and I saw him on TV.
Okay.
And when I talked to him, he seems to know everything. Ah. He's very intelligent and very focused. So this is the man.
Mm. So he's accepted your offer?
Yeah, I think so.
What's his, position?
More of a consultant.
Because he does tours, I believe, around Manila.
And, he has tourism from A to Z. Yeah, that's true.
Nang Maynila,
I'm very much impressed.
All right, so you have him in your team as well.
Yeah. I get the best people. Competent people with unquestionable integrity. That's why I know.
Any other prominent personalities you have tucked in your sleeve or part of your team? Maliban kay Margo.
Actually, you know, my former cabinet members are helping me.
Who?
Like for example, the finances, the Ben Jokno, Secretary Ben Jokno. You know, he's an economic professor. Philip Midaya, who used to be the dean of the UP Economic. Cultural economic, and of course, Secretary Pardo, my former finance secretary, they're all helping me.
Talaga.
Yeah.
Who else, apart from Secretary Pardo and Ben Jokno?
Well,
do you have your others? Because I remember your health secretary at that time was Romualdez.
Sa health.
Oh.
Yeah.
You also
he's
have
a WHO consultant, you know, he's very, very competent.
How about Senator Ping?
Why not? In fact, I've been talking to Senator Lacson for the peace and order situation in Manila because he used to be my crime buster.
Exactly, sir. Yeah. So,
he gave me some pointers, you know, help me.
He gave you pointers, but...
Yeah.
You know, pending there's a cabinet appointment kay Senator Ping Lacson, would it have been nice to actually have him, although, you know, work with you in, I don't know, in what some kind of capacity?
He's already a national figure, and I think he'll be given an important cabinet post by the president now. Mm. So I just asked his advice, mm-hmm. because he has that experience, and he had proven it, you know, when I signed him as the chief PMP, and he was able to deliver. Well, before that, before he became chief PMP, the survey of, among the, I mean, at the PMP is always in the negative. But when he became chief PMP, in a few months, the approval rating went up to 53% positive. So he proved himself.
Yeah. Senator Ping has done a lot, especially nung, I mean, you know, naiba ho din talaga yung image ng PNP that time. I mean, as far as yung pagbigay po ng permit to carry ng mga baril, tinutukan niya talaga yan.
That's the same thing I want to happen in Manila. Bring back the image of the Manila police to Manila's finest.
So who is your top person there for peace and order, sir?
Well, I got one who was used to be also with Senator Lacson, with the name of Gilbert Cruz, who is now the deputy chief of police.
Gilbert Cruz, sir? Yeah. Yung si Gilbert Cruz ba yung galing sa Makati at na punta po sa Calabar Zone?
Yeah.
Okay, siya po. Mm. You got him as what?
Well, as deputy chief of police.
So he's with you now?
Yeah.
So natanggal na pala po siya doon. Okay, yeah, he did. Yeah, I remember him in Makati, sir.
Yeah.
Yung kamukha na kahawig ni Gabby Concepcion. Siya na pala.
He's very experienced and very intelligent, capable policeman.
So exciting.
He has a very good record.
Uh-huh.
He used to be chief of police after his stint with the PAOC and the PACC. He became chief of police of San Juan. Then after being chief of police of San Juan, he became chief of police of Makati.
I didn't know he came from San Juan.
Yeah.
So. I see.
No, after his stint with the PAOC.
All right, so at least you have you feel that you are in good hands.
Oh, yes, yes.
With
he's one of the most trusted police that I have now.
Did you promise, sir, the teachers na hindi po nabigyan ng kanilang na-delay yung kanyang mga allowance na maibabalik niyo?
Once we are financially, you know, stable, that will be my priority. Mga teachers and mga police. Because, you know, mga teacher, paano makagawa ng mga lesson plan yan kung mag-iisip sila problema niya ng fund, ng pera. Especially the police, kaya na-involve sa mga kotong-kotong yan, sa mga kidnapping because of, you know, hungry stomach knows no law.
Do you feel that they're afraid now that you're in?
I hope so, because I'm in business. And, you know, even Ping Lacson knows that when I got him.
On a last note, Mayor Erap, kamusta na ho kayo ni Mayor Lim?
So-so.
So-so? Ano po yung so-so?
You know, I mean, the guy, when we were candidates, he said that he has nothing to do about filing the disqualification case against me. They filed 3 disqualification cases against me. One in Sandigan Bayan, it was dismissed. And then the RTC, it was dismissed. And then the Comelec, they filed another disqualification. The 3 disqualifications, and they were all dismissed.
Mm-hmm.
So then after the election, I was proclaimed winner by the Comelec. And he, you know, he
conceded
and admitted that he lost. No?
Yeah.
And in fact, he offered to help.
Yeah, that's true.
Huh? Oh, imagine he filed another disqualification case against him in the Supreme Court. You see what kind of man he is. Huh? He conceded already, and then again, he filed a disqualification case against him in the Supreme Court. What kind of a person is he? You cannot trust him. You know?
Bothered ka ba? I mean, even things like that, does it bother me? I mean, babalikan ko lang po very quickly.
As much as possible, you don't like to talk about him.
Hindi kasi, di ba, from the time na magkasama ho kayo, nakulong kayo, pumunta ho siya sa inyo sa Tanay, humingi naman tulong sa inyo, tapos pagkatapos na, nanalo po si Mayor, naka-alis po kayo ng, you know, you were back dito po sa, ay natanggal na po kayo sa kulungan dahil nga nabigyan kayo ng, ano, ng presidente. Tapos, para bang, away kayo ng meron, parang palaging may conflict.
Hindi, hindi kami nag-aawayan yun. Nung tumakbo siya ng presidente, laban sa akin. 1998. Pang-apat yata kami tumakbo, pang-apat siya. Tapos naawa ko sa kanya, in-appoint yung nakiusap, in-appoint yung DILG secretary.
Right.
Okay. Nagkakagulo na sa Malacanang, sabi, papaalam siya. Ayusin daw niya yung mga polis. Yun pala, hindi niya inayos. Tuloy-tuloy siya doon sa Estrados. In-stop lang siya ni... I don't love you. Anyone to talk
okay,
about it?
Okay, let's not talk about it. Sorry, sir. May nakalimutan po ako. Plans number one, pag-aralan niyo na ho ba yung oil spill na nangyari po doon? Dahil wala daw permit yung...
Hindi pa. I've not gone over it. This is only my fourth day. Fifth day.
So, no update on that, sir? We're going to
take it up with the city council. Okay. I think the vice mayor is more versed about this problem.
Ah, mas alam po niya yan. And lastly, what are your plans or your thoughts on the oil depots in Pandacan, sir?
Ako without, I've not gone over it, but on hindsight, I would say that they should be removed. That's it's a dangerous, it's not a place for that depot. In fact, it's near Malacanang. Once, accident can happen, once it's blown up, Malacanang will be affected.
So if you had it your way?
That should be relocated. Relocated.
Right. Former president and, of course, Manila Mayor Joseph Erap Estrada. Sir, always a pleasure to have you. It's your fifth day. Good luck. You have 3 more years to go.
Pray for Manila. I hope, I'll do my best. This is the biggest challenge. And the last challenge of my life. And I cannot fail. I should not fail. I hope. And I'll pray hard.
Yeah.
And I ask the help of everyone. Because this does not involve only the people of Manila, the whole country. Because Manila is the show window, the image of the Philippines. So I'm asking the help and the cooperation of everybody, not only the Malilenos, but every Filipino, that once Manila is, you know, by the way, I've been abroad, you know, they know Manila more than the Philippines. You're from Manila.
That's true.
So that's why I'm very thankful to President Noynoy that he'll give this big budget for clearing up the esteros and the relocation of the former settlers and improving and the stretch of the Ross Boulevard. So this is a big help to the Manila.
All right. Again, Arwell, good luck to you, sir. And we can only hope, wish the best for you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Blessed John Paul II could become a saint this year and plan holders mull a complaint against Philippine Prudential Life Insurance. The details when mornings at ANC returns.